much for this day, Lord. I thank you for bringing us all here safely, and I pray for anyone sitting in front of me right now that doesn't know you as your Savior, Lord, that I pray for them and that they come to you and that they realize what Christmas is all about, and that you sent your one and only child to die for us and save us from our sins. And if that wasn't for you, I probably wouldn't be standing here praying to you right now. I thank you so much, and I pray that everything goes well. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Silent night. We thank you for coming this evening. As you can see, God has given these young people a great deal of talent. And we hope you enjoyed this evening, but we also hope that you were listening closely to the words, that God can use that in your life for encouragement, blessing. Sometimes it's conviction. This isn't mine. We're going to close with one more song, and then Mr. Errol's going to come and has a closing prayer for us. I'm going to ask you, because you've been such a good audience, to stand up. Everybody, stand up. Oh, doesn't that feel good? We're going to ask you to stand for this last number. This is our benediction. We thank you so much for coming. Once again, all this goes back. And so if you feel like you'd like to stretch and exercise a little more tonight, come see me and I have things you can move. Thank you so much for coming. And we wish you the most blessed of Christmases.
Christmas Eve, and if you know anything about the programs here at the NAS, You're not going to want to miss that. Let's close in prayer. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you that you came to us in the form of a baby. You demonstrated your love to us. While we were still sinners, you sent your Son who died on the cross for us. Father, that extravagant love, we want to celebrate. We want to share in music and in word and in our actions. Father, help us to be faithful to communicating that message to the lost and dying. Father, we thank you for these students and their talents, and we pray that you were pleased by what was sung and played tonight, because this was for your glory alone, because you alone deserve it. We love you and thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good night.
You watched the tape in Ferguson, no, but I wasn't interviewing people in St. Louis.
Right.
So, yeah, there is police abuse. You got 800,000 cops. Some of them will be sadists or jerks, and they won't do it to you or to me because we're known and we're white. But some of them will abuse people.
I know, but you don't shut down a whole society, and, you know, ambulances can't get through, and yeah. There's accidents, and looting. The guy goes, looting's okay.
That's nuts and wrong. Right. No argument for me there.
Okay. But the protesters, I don't think, understand the big picture. I mean, Russell Simmons, I hope he comes in tomorrow to talk with us. He's a sincere guy. We've had him on the program before. But he's comparing federal grand juries to state and local grand juries. You can't do that.
They can indict a ham sandwich. They almost never indict cops.
Right, because police are given the benefit of doubt, as we talked about last night, because they are in difficult circumstances a lot of these times, and there is a lot of violence against the cops.
But I don't think Russell Simmons knows much about anything.
Well, no, I'm
stick it up for Simmons.
All right.
We'll see what he has. And he's got enough guts to come in here. You got to admire it. When you talk to the limousine liberals on the Upper West Side of Manhattan, okay, most of them don't have cars, so they're not getting famous. And then, you know, if it's a car, is that they're going to be sympathetic to it? Where I said the word, which is the first one.
This time, the government has been able to get a diagnosis of a disease, and then visit all the drinkers of the home.